Basically what I'm going to do is go on Pandora. Oh, let me turn this on. And I'm just going to click some random channels, and I want you guys to tell me what channel it is and how the music makes you feel, or what mood it puts you in. Okay, so here's the first one. And I don't know what song it's going to play, so I'm sorry if it's going to be really weird.
Frustrated.
That brings back an old memory and makes you cry because it's a sad memory or something like that. That's physically. Or exercising when you want to run faster. That's physically. And psychologically as well with the exercise one because it messes with your brain. Or relaxation, it messes with your brain too because it relaxes certain nerves in your brain that makes you your whole body relax better. Have you ever heard of aroma or yoga or dance or even chest therapy? Have you ever heard of music therapy? Has anyone here ever heard of music therapy? Raise your hand. You have. Okay, great. Has anyone ever took part in it or know someone who's taken part in music therapy? Really? See, it's not really popular around here, which is kind of sad because Archville doesn't really have many facilities where you could put music therapy in. But you'll find more music therapy facilities in big cities because there's bigger hospitals and bigger clinics there. So, this is why I'm such an advocate for music therapy, because I think that's a great thing. So, I'm going to start by saying that music therapy, this is the official definition. It says music therapy is the use of music interventions to accomplish individualized goals within a therapeutic relationship. Now, I know that's just a bunch of words for you guys. Basically, what it is, it's like any other therapy, but the treatment is used with music. which is pretty cool. They just use different things with music. You can find music therapy clinics or music therapists in hospitals, in psychiatric hospitals, in nursing homes, and even schools. Basically, what music therapy is used for is communication. People who have large stutters. I don't know if any of you have seen or saw American Idol this past season, but there was a boy on there who had a severe stutter when he talked. But magically, it went away when he sang, which was really kind of cool. It's really amazing. And another thing that it works with is movement. Someone who has been in an accident or had knee surgery, and if they're moving to a beat, just, you know, back and forth, that's one way that music therapy is used with that. Also, neurologically, for example, people who have head injuries, severe head injuries, it's used very often, especially with repetition, to get their brains moving again. Also, cancer patients, as you can see, is used a lot with. And also, Alzheimer's disease with the elderly, most likely, it's used with that, because repetition in lyrics or something can help very much so. Music therapy is very well known in the autism world. A lot of clinics for music therapy work hand in hand with autism patients because for some reason autism patients connect very well with music and music therapy helps them express their feelings a little bit better than they would be able to. And even music therapy can help with healthy people because if you're stressed or you have lots of really bad anxiety, then music therapy can help really well with that because just by listening to relaxing music, you can lay down and feel your body relax, and it's a lot, and you feel a lot better than you did before. So, treatment for music therapy, basically what a music therapist does on a daily basis is they figure out what the patient needs, what their strengths are, and what they need on their first visit. And then their next visits, the music therapist by themselves creates some kind of treatment using music, obviously. Anybody from an infant to the very oldest of the elderly can take part in music therapy. There's no age limit. And treatment can consist of creating music. For example, creating lyrics to a song can help for people with autism mostly creating music is used for. Singing music. Singing, for example, repetition, like I said, for Alzheimer's or brain injury patients. That's used a lot. Just singing music, like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. We all know that by memory, but these patients may not, so they keep singing it, so by the next time, they might have it memorized, which can help a lot with the brain, just different areas. It's really cool. Also, moving, like I said, with patients who need movement, and listening to music, like I said, with the relaxation. You just listen to music and it makes you feel better somehow. So music therapy basically started around Aristotle's time. Aristotle thought of it, really. And it really came about in the 20th century, around the World War I and World War II. Because in hospitals, musicians would just come in and they would play music, and patients, for some reason, doctors would analyze these patients and see that they were feeling a lot better. And they couldn't figure out why. So when they figured out that it was basically the music that made them feel better, they started hiring these musicians to come into the hospital. Well, that was a good thing and a bad thing, because the bad thing about hiring a musician is the fact that they're not really trained in a hospital setting. So that was when music therapy came about. And people started making curriculums and training programs so these people could be qualified enough to go into a hospital and use their music as treatment. And that's basically how music therapy courses started for college and things like that. These pictures right here are just some examples of treatment that they have used. For example, finishing a lyric to a song, or a simple spelling rule, like they would use that in school, like I for E except for E. We all know that, right? But it helps in schooling when you're learning something. So here are a couple testimonies that I wanted to share with you guys. This is Ida Goldman, and she is a 90-year-old who had movement problems, and she was actually couldn't walk. But when she gave this speech, she walked to the podium, and this is what she said. Before I had surgery, they told me I could never walk again. When I sat and listened to music, I forgot all about the pain. I thought that was really cool. Next, this was written by an actual music therapist who worked with this guy named Mr. Smith. And the name is Sharon Graham. And for some reason, it's not showing the whole thing. But anyway, it says, music allowed Mr. Smith to die peacefully. The two songs that he specifically requested conveyed the messages he needed to share before departing from this world. Music therapy provided him the crucial... let me go back and I'll open up for you. The crucial opportunity or medium to express what he felt. My time with Mr. Smith instilled in me a powerfully transformative thought. The music of our lives remains long after our bodies pass away. The love contained herein is eternal and will last beyond our pain. I thought that was pretty cool because it's from a different point of view. You had the point of view of the patient, and now you have the point of view of the actual music therapist and what they get out of it. It's pretty cool. So, basically, with my whole spiel, lecture, call it what you will, the point I wanted to make, or I hope at least you've learned, is that it's amazing how something that we use as entertainment can be used to heal people. And actually, it saves lives, which is really, really cool. And that's why I'm such an advocate and I'm so passionate about music therapy. And I'll leave you with the last quote by Henry Reed, and I agree with him very much so, and it just kind of wraps up what I mean by this whole lecture. Henry Reed said, simply put, music can heal people. Thank you. And now, if you have any questions, lay them on me.
Is that something that you're going to want to go into in the future?
Yeah, that's what I plan to do next year in college.
Is it an actual major, or are there just classes offered?
There are definitely majors. There are in certain schools. It's not in a lot of universities, and it's hard to find, but there are definitely schools that have music therapy majors. And actually, it starts out with a bachelor's degree, and you can get master's, but really what you want to get to the point of taking a certified test from the national board, and then that makes you a certified music therapist, and then that will get you places. Anything else?
Can music have a negative effect on someone?
Can music have a negative effect? Sure it can. I mean, have you ever been sleeping and someone's banging loud music next to you in a different room and you just like stop and it just annoys you because it messes with the kind of, because your brain's already focused on sleeping, and if someone's banging loud music then it's trying to, you know, it's getting all this, it's just, you know, oh sorry, it's just messing with your train of thought already. So yeah, of course it can. But I don't think it's, I think mostly it has positive effects if you use it in that way. Anything else? Don't be shy. Yes.
How did you first find out about music therapy?
Actually, a cousin of mine is involved or wanted to go into music therapy, and I had no clue what it was, so I asked him about it, and like, I obviously, a lot of you who know me know that I'm a music freak. I don't really, I'm not really involved in anything else, so it's something I'm passionate about, so I went on Google, researched it, and researched it, and researched it, and then I went and I asked him, actually, if any of you guys know Allie McQuaid, she's a freshman. Her mom is actually a music therapist. And before I decided to actually want to be in this major, I called her mom and I asked her questions about it. So, yeah. It's not really known. Not a lot of people know about it. Because whenever I tell people, they're like, what? But, yeah.
Has it gotten more popular over the years?
Yeah, it's actually really popular right now, which is why I'm glad I'm going into it, because people are more aware of the effects of music, and people are more aware that music therapy is an actual thing. and it's actually used in hospitals if you request it, mostly. But yeah, it's gotten a lot more popular. Yeah.
Oh, you might. Sorry.
I thought you were